Good evening and welcome to Rajya Sabha TV. My name is Aditi Nagpal Girotra and you're watching news tonight. Let's get the news rolling with the headlines first. Prime Minister Narendra Modi addresses BJP workers on the occasion of Pandit Deen Dayal Upadhyay's 104th birth anniversary, recalls Pandit Deen Dayal's support for Swadeshi and says the reformist decisions taken by the government in recent times have the imprint of the vision shown by him. Bihar Assembly elections to be held in three phases on October 28th, November 3rd and November 7th, counting of votes on November 10th. This will be the biggest electoral exercise globally to be held amid the COVID-19 pandemic. Scientists like Professor Satish Dhawan play a big role in the success of the Indian space program, writes Prime Minister Narendra Modi. In his valedictory address at the Dr. Vikram Sarabhai Centenary Program, President Ramnath Kovind recalls contributions of the father of the Indian space program. Modi government's flagship scheme Make in India completes 6 years. Many infrastructure projects launched under the scheme over the years to give boost to small and local businesses. And it's the end of an era in music. Legendary singer S.P. Balasubramaniam loses his battle with COVID-19 and passes away. President, Vice President and Prime Minister mourn the death of the playback singer. Prime Minister Narendra Modi addressed BJP workers and took part in the celebrations of the Foundation Day of the Deen Dayal Upadhyay Grameen Kaushalya Yojana on the occasion of the leader's birth anniversary. The event was also attended by BJP National President JP Nadda and Defence Minister Rajnath Singh.
On the 104th birth anniversary of Bharatiya Jan Sangh leader Pandit Deen Dayal Upadhyay, Prime Minister Narendra Modi highlighted his valuable contributions to make India a better country. Interacting with workers of the Bharatiya Janata Party, Modi said, Pandit Deen Dayal Upadhyay's ideas and teachings on politics, economics and various other fields will keep inspiring generations to come. Recalling that Pandit Deen Dayal advocated the idea of Swadeshi, Modi said his birth anniversary this year is even more relevant as the reformist decisions taken by the government in recent times had the imprint of the vision shown by him.
21वीं सदी के भारत को विश्व पटल पर नई ऊंचाई देने के लिए 130 करोड़ से अधिक भारतीयों के जीवन को बेहतर बनाने के लिए आज जो कुछ भी हो रहा है उसमें दीनदयाल जी जैसे महान व्यक्तित्वों का बहुत बड़ा आशीर्वाद है। इस बार उनका जन्मदिवस इसलिए भी विशेष है क्योंकि बीते कुछ दिनों में ही देश ने वो अहम निर्णय किए हैं जिस पर पंडित दीनदयाल उपाध्याय जी के चिंतन की प्रकाश रेखाएं हैं, प्रकाश पुंज है।
Speaking about the agricultural reforms bills passed by Parliament during the monsoon session, Prime Minister Modi hit out at the opposition parties for misleading farmers for their own political benefit. He urged BJP leaders and workers to reach out to farmers on the ground and inform them about details and benefits of the new agricultural reforms and how these will empower them.
झूठ बोलने वाले कुछ लोग इन दिनों अपने राजनीतिक स्वार्थ की वजह से किसानों के कंधे पर बंदूकें फोड़ रहे हैं, किसानों को भ्रमित करने में लगे हैं। ये लोग अफवाहें फैला रहे हैं। देश के किसानों को ऐसी किसी भी अफवाह से बचाना कृषि सुधार का महत्व समझाना भारतीय जनता पार्टी के हम सभी कार्यकर्ताओं का बहुत बड़ा कर्तव्य है, हमारी जिम्मेवारी है, क्योंकि हमें किसान के भविष्य को सुनिश्चित करना है, उज्जवल बनाना है।
The Prime Minister also lauded the new labor laws passed by Parliament, asserting that they will ensure timely salary for over 50 crore organized and unorganized workers. Modi asserted that his government's mantra and karma is nation first, adding that it is fitting that faceless assessment of tax filings, one of the biggest reforms in our tax system, comes into effect on the birth anniversary of Pandit Deen Dayal Upadhyay.
ईमानदार करदाताओं को परेशानी ना हो, इसके लिए फेसलेस टैक्स सिस्टम कुछ महीने पहले ही टैक्स रिजिम का हिस्सा हो चुका है। अब वहां से ऊपर अपील में जाना है। अब फेसलेस अपील का प्रावधान करदाताओं को अनावश्यक रूप से परेशान करने की प्रवृत्ति से बहुत बड़ी सुरक्षा देगा।
The Prime Minister also praised the efforts of the BJP workers in fighting the challenge posed by the COVID-19 pandemic and paid tribute to those who lost their lives while serving others. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
BJP President JP Nadda also addressed Pandit Deen Dayal Upadhyay's 104th birth anniversary celebrations in Jaipur through video conference. Remembering the party ideologue, Nadda said he advocated for an ideology which is self-sustainable and close to Indian traditions. He said the BJP-led NDA government is working on Pandit Deen Dayal's principle of Antyodaya, which calls for eradication of poverty and provision of basic needs of every family and correcting the imbalances in the country.
स्वच्छ भारत मिशन के तहत 11 करोड़ इज्जत घर बना करके हमारे 11 करोड़ परिवारों की इज्जत को बचाया भी और उनको सम्मान से जीने का अधिकार दिया। इस बात को हमको समझना चाहिए। यही कोविड के स्थिति में 20 करोड़ बहनों के खाते में प्रधानमंत्री मोदी जी ने सीधा दिल्ली से 500-500-1500 रुपए 3 महीने तक कोविड में उनको पहुंचा दिया, ताकि उनके घर का चूल्हा जल सके। इस बात को हमको ध्यान में रखना चाहिए। प्रधानमंत्री आवास योजना, 1.5 करोड़ लोगों के घर पर छत की व्यवस्था की गई, पक्के मकान की व्यवस्था की गई, और संकल्प लिया कि 2022 तक इस देश में कोई नहीं रहेगा जिसके ऊपर पक्के छत का मकान नहीं होगा, पक्के छत का मकान बनेगा, यह बात का संकल्प लिया गया।
The Election Commission has announced dates for Bihar elections. With this, Bihar will be the first state to go to polls amid the COVID-19 pandemic. Here are the details.
Voting for the Bihar Assembly elections will be held in 3 phases, the Election Commission announced on Friday. The first phase will be held on October 28th, in which 71 Assembly constituencies will go to polls. In the second phase, on November 3rd, voting will be held for 94 Assembly seats. Voting for the third and final phase will take place on November 7th for 78 seats. Counting of all votes will take place on 10th November.
10 districts will have 2 phases of elections for logistical reasons. 28 districts will have single phase elections. Patna and Bhagalpur districts will have elections in the first as well as second phase. 8 districts, namely Darbhanga, Madhubani, Purva Champaran, Pashchim Champaran, Muzaffarpur, Vaishali, Samastipur and Sitamadhi will have elections in second and third phases.
The Election Commission said that the Bihar polls will be held under strict COVID-19 safety measures. Candidates can file their nominations online. Candidates can also deposit security money online. Only 5 persons, including the candidate, are allowed for door-to-door campaigning. Voting time will be extended by 1 hour and votes could be cast from 7 a.m. till 6 p.m., except in the left-wing extremism-affected areas. COVID-19 patients will be allowed to cast their vote in the last hour of the voting period. Postal ballot facility will be provided wherever required and requested. Social distancing norms will need to be followed at public gatherings during the poll campaign.
Over 7 lakh hand sanitizer units, about 46 lakh masks, 6 lakh PPE kits, 6.7 lakh units of face shields, and 23 lakh pairs of hand gloves have been arranged for the polls. For voters specifically, 7.2 crore single-use hand gloves have been provisioned. Chief Election Commissioner Sunil Arora said, "These will be one of the biggest elections globally to be held during the prevailing COVID-19 situation."
Door-to-door campaigning has been restricted to 5 persons, including the candidate. Road shows are allowed, subject to the convoy being broken after every 5 vehicles. All election meetings and gatherings will have to adhere strictly to the health and safety protocols and shall be monitored at all levels by the election and health machinery in the field in the various districts of Bihar.
With the announcement of the poll schedule, Model Code of Conduct has come into effect in Bihar. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Remembering Professor Satish Dhawan on his 100th birth anniversary, Prime Minister Narendra Modi said he has played a key role in the success of the Indian space program. The Prime Minister credited Dhawan for the recognition enjoyed globally by India's space program. Underlining the difficulties Professor Dhawan had to face to get education, PM Modi said that he took the responsibility of taking India to a path of immense opportunities. In a written message, the Prime Minister said, "Taking inspiration from Professor Dhawan, the government has decided to open India's space program to other sectors." He added further that creating awareness among Indian youth about science and technology would be a true tribute to Professor Satish Dhawan. President Ramnath Kovind today hailed Dr. Vikram Sarabhai as a world-class scientist, a policymaker, and also an institution builder who convened an army of brilliant scientists, anthropologists, communicators, and social scientists to spearhead the Indian space program.
Addressing the birth centenary program of Dr. Vikram Sarabhai through video conferencing on Friday, President Kovind paid tribute to Dr. Sarabhai and recalled the contributions of the father of the Indian space program. He said, "For both Dr. Sarabhai and Dr. Bhabha, science was not only an exciting journey in itself, but was also a path to modern development for a country like India."
It is noteworthy that for both Dr. Sarabhai and Dr. Bhabha, science was not only an exciting journey in itself, but was also a path to modern development for a country like India. Ladies and gentlemen, when the whole world was using space for military domination, Dr. Sarabhai thought that for India, with its immense size and diversity, the space technology is the suitable platform for fast-track development.
The president said that as a scientist, Dr. Sarabhai was never content with merely noting observations. He always looked into the implications of the experimental data for a better understanding of the nature of the interplanetary space.
Dr. Vikram Sarabhai, father of Indian space program, is one of them. A man of singular charm, he was full of humility that masked his tall achievements. He was a world-class scientist, a policy maker, and also an institution builder, a rarest of rare combination.
Appreciating the vision of Dr. Sarabhai, the president said he wanted to demonstrate the usefulness of a satellite system for national development. He said, "Today we realize the significance of his dream when the COVID-19 pandemic has failed to interrupt school education that has continued in the remote learning mode."
Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla has hailed the opposition and Treasury benches members for sitting extra hours to complete the allotted business of the House. He also thanked the media for its coverage of the monsoon session of Parliament amidst a global pandemic. He said that on an average, 370 members were present for the proceedings on a daily basis, and that while the total hours allotted to Lok Sabha was only 37, it worked for 60 hours.
इस परिस्थिति के अंदर हमें जिस तरीके का सहयोग सभी दलों के नेताओं का मिला, सभी मान्य सदस्यों का मिला, सरकार का मिला, उसके कारण हम कम समय के अंदर ज्यादा काम कर पाए और हमारी उत्पादकता प्रोडक्टिविटी 167% रही, जो अपने आप में ऐतिहासिक है।
Government's flagship scheme, Make in India, has completed 6 years. The scheme was launched by Prime Minister Modi to make India a manufacturing hub and attract FDI. In 6 years, many infrastructure projects have been launched under the scheme, which has also given a boost to small and local businesses. Here's a look at the journey of the Make in India program.
Aaj Make in India, ye nara nahi hai. Ye Make in India. ये सिर्फ निमंत्रण नहीं है, मेक इन इंडिया ये हम सबकी जिम्मेवारी है। हम सब जिम्मेवारी के साथ अगर आगे बढ़ेंगे और हम भारत के लोग एक बार करेंगे तो दुनिया के लोग जरूर हमारे यहाँ आएंगे।
6 years ago, Prime Minister Narendra Modi launched one of the flagship schemes of his government, Make in India. A major national program to give a much needed thrust to the manufacturing sector and reduce our dependency on imports. The scheme aimed to facilitate investment, foster innovation, enhance skill development and build best-in-class manufacturing infrastructure. In the past 6 years, the scheme has managed to achieve several of its objectives and foreign direct investments in India has witnessed a positive trend since the launch of the Make in India campaign in 2014. FDI inflow from April 2014 to March 2020 is 52.5% of the overall FDI received since April 2000. For the first time, India crossed the $70 billion mark in the financial year 2019-20. The scheme aims to drive economic growth and improve quality of life by industrial and urban infrastructure development. Projects like industrial corridors, national highways, Sagarmala, railway stations and modernization are underway. The government has launched several reforms to ensure ease of doing business in India. India is ranked 63rd in the World Bank Ease of Doing Business Report 2020 among the chosen 190 countries. The government is also encouraging innovation and entrepreneurship through the Make in India scheme. India has been ranked as the 48th most innovative nation in the world in 2020 by the Global Innovation Index, entering the top 50 for the first time. Coupled with the center's Atmanirbhar Bharat campaign launched during the COVID-19 pandemic, the Make in India scheme is playing a key role in promoting small businesses and local manufacturing. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
With this, we'll slip into a short break, but we'll be back soon. Stay tuned with us.
Watch The Big Picture with me, Vishal Dahiya, at 9:30 p.m. on Rajya Sabha TV.
Ghata, one of the oldest and most unique percussion instruments of southern India. You can play it not only with your fingers, but palms, wrists and heels as well. You'd be surprised, but the air inside the ghatam reverberates, creating the musical notes. 5 elements of nature, earth, water, air, fire and space, make up the composition of this beautiful musical piece, which has found an apt place in most of the ancient books.
Welcome back. You're still with us on News Tonight. Let's take a look at the COVID-19 situation in the country.
India on Friday reported 86,052 new COVID-19 cases and 1,141 deaths. With this, the total infections in the country have now crossed 58.18 lakh. Recoveries have crossed 47.56 lakh, while 92,290 people have lost their lives. The overall recovery rate in the country is 81.7%. Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, Kerala and Tamil Nadu reported the highest increase in cases in the last 24 hours. Kerala reported the highest daily cases in the state so far on Thursday. The state has added 11,000 cases in the last 2 days alone. On Wednesday, the state reported 5,376 cases, crossing the 5,000 a day mark for the first time. Kerala now has more than 1.54 lakh confirmed cases, of which nearly 46,000 are active. Cases in the state are growing at 3.38%, more than twice the national growth rate. Maharashtra, Punjab, Uttar Pradesh, Tamil Nadu and Karnataka reported the highest increase in the number of deaths in the last 24 hours. Daily testing picked up pace today after a week-long decline. India tested 14.92 lakh samples on Thursday, taking the total testing to 6.89 crore. The positivity rate is 8.6%. Bureau report, Rajya Sabha TV.
American firm Novavax has begun a late-stage trial of its potential COVID-19 vaccine in the United Kingdom. Trials will involve around 10,000 people aged between 18 and 84. The trial is being conducted in partnership with the UK government's Vaccine Task Force, which was created in April to speed up the development of a COVID-19 vaccine. In another development, China's Sinovac started phase 3 clinical trials for its potential COVID-19 vaccine in Turkey on Friday. The vaccine will be administered to more than 1,000 volunteering health workers over 10 days. Under a vaccine emergency use program, China is administering experimental coronavirus vaccines to its people while clinical trials are still underway. At least three vaccine candidates, including two developed by China National Biotech Group and one from Sinovac Biotech, are included in the emergency use program. All these vaccines are undergoing phase 3 trials overseas. Prime Minister Narendra Modi had a telephonic conversation with his Japanese counterpart, Yoshihide Suga, on Friday. In a Twitter message, PM Modi said they exchanged views on the tremendous progress in relationship between the two countries in the last few years and the future direction of our special strategic and global partnership. He said they also agreed that stronger India-Japan ties would help meet the challenges of the current regional and global situation. It was their first phone call since Yoshihide Suga took office as Japan's Prime Minister last week. Providing a breather for companies to recover from coronavirus pandemic-induced financial stress, the government has extended the suspension of fresh insolvency proceedings by 3 months till 25th of December. A Gazette notification issued in this respect said that the suspension of Section 7, 9 and 10 of the IBC Code, initially for 6 months, has been further extended for another 3 months, starting from 25th September 2020. The 6 month period of suspension, effective from 25th March, was to end on 24th September. Government will review the situation before the latest extension expires, and another 3 month extension will be granted only if necessary. The IBC Amendment Bill was brought in to replace an ordinance that was promulgated in June to protect firms from being dragged into insolvency proceedings. Ayush Minister Shripad Yesho Naik and Union Minister Dr. Jitendra Singh on Friday jointly inaugurated the Post-Harvest Management Centre for Medicinal Plants in Jammu and Kashmir's Bhadarwah region. The inauguration was done through a digital event. The PHM will facilitate drying, sorting, processing, certification, packaging and scientific storage of herbal raw materials produced and collected by locals, giving value and better price to farmers. The ministers also launched 21 Ayush health and wellness centers in Jammu and Kashmir.